how the pro-Israel advocacy movement can counter the pro-Palestinian anti-Israel movement. There needs to be a paradigm shift in our narrative, because they, no matter what we counter with, they have organizations on their side that they can always quote to back up what they say. The UN, B'Tselem, Human Rights Watch, just anything. So, and they can consider that their source. And there's nothing you can say to counter that. So you just have to stop caring. The way in which we need to state our narrative is we need to flip the script. They have taken our narrative. They have co-opted our narrative, our history, our indigeneity to this land. They are the occupiers in this land. They are the colonizers in this land. The Arabs, Palestinians are occupying Jewish land. And so our narrative should be the same as theirs. We should take our narrative back. They have stolen our narrative. They have stolen Jewish land. From the river to the sea, Israel will be free. This is our land, and we have every right to resist their occupation in this land. They have committed terror attacks and made it impossible to live with them. So this is now what we have to say. The time is over for peace. There is no more peace. No justice for the unaliving of our civilians. No peace for their civilians. There are no innocent Palestinians. When they celebrate in the streets every time one of us is unalived, there are no innocent Palestinians. They support Hamas. They support the terrorism to continue. They don't want to live with us. They've shown that. Why should we care about their lives? They don't care about our lives. So quit trying to justify and equivocate, you know, our civilians with protecting their civilians. We have no right to protect and incur people who are trying to kill us or who support trying to kill us. If the people in Gaza are so innocent, they would give up Hamas. They would flee instead of staying. They would do something besides supporting the continued terror. So there is no innocent Palestinians in Gaza or in the West Bank. They are committed to our destruction. And so we need to treat them as such. And so whenever the pro-Palestinian people are continuing to support this narrative of occupation and the justification of terror, we need to now call them out and say that they are supporting terrorists and to do whatever we can do to shut them out of our space. We need to stand up and fight and demand that the people that support terror do not have a place in a society, in a job, in a public space, on social media, anywhere. And so we need to call that out. And then also, we need to, not just people on social media, but the government, the Israeli government, needs to stop caring about what the rest of the world thinks about us and state unequivocally that we are going to do what we need to do to get rid of the people that are trying to kill us, whether that be civilians or part of a terror organization like Hamas or Islamic Jihad. And we can't count on anybody, the U.S., the UN, our Arab neighbors that we are supposed to have a peace treaty with, if they can't call out Hamas and call it a terror organization and support Israel's right to exist and the rooting out of everybody that supports terror. And so we need to say that firmly and strongly, from the prime minister all the way down, the diplomats, the UN ambassadors, foreign ministers, everybody needs to be more aggressive and not be afraid to say that we are going to protect ourselves and our land and our homeland, and that we belong in this land.